in. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up you guys? It's Craft Farms here, back again with another video. And today we're back on Dad's farm. I'm just taking the grain cart over to the field right now. We are starting on soybeans. As you can see, our beans are fully grown here. Got the combine. I recorded all the courses for the combine to run all the beans. I got the combine set up here on field 9. I got the truck ready to rock and roll. All we got to do here is get the grain cart course recorded, and then we'll be ready to rock and roll. The beans are yielding surprisingly well. I guess not surprisingly, because these fields here had the slurry on them. So I guess, yeah, it makes sense that they're yielding pretty well. I'm trying to think what fields didn't. Field 11 didn't have slurry, and then 15 and 16. So we should run pretty well with our beans. You know, the combine didn't hit very far, and it's full already. I did have a little accident with the combine. I totally forgot that the combine will blow straw even on the road. So when I started the combine on the course, I drove it a little bit to get in, you know, get started on cutting. And yeah, I kind of screwed up, and now there's bean chaff all over the road. But no biggie, it'll go away with soil mod. So we're gonna unload the combine here, and then we'll record a course for both of these fields. We only need one course since they're butted up together. Today is Thursday, and I'm recording this. The video for today just went live a few hours ago. I was actually gone. I was helping my uncle. He's working construction, and he asked if I wanted to help him hang some sheetrock, or not hang it, but move it inside from the pile that it was in. And so I went and helped him with that. I basically sat and ran the skid steer, and we moved it from the skid steer, or from the pile onto the skid steer, and from the skid steer down the hill to where the basement door was. And then we, I don't know what that was. Then I basically just sat in the skid steer and raised it up and down and drove it around, and it was a lot of fun. That was quite the skid steer. It was a Bobcat A770, I think is what it said on it. Very, very nice Bobcat. It you could choose between the normal Bobcat option of where, you know, you can basically spin on a dime, or you could make it so that the wheels would pivot, you know, with the way that you're turning. And that was quite the thing to get used to doing that, because, well, and then also it has, you know, it still has the two joysticks, but the right hand joystick runs your bucket and loader, and then the left hand side ran the skid steer. And that was quite the thing to get used to, because all the other times that I've run a Bobcat or a skid steer in general, it was you had your two handles here and your foot pedals for, you know, the rest of your stuff. And it was just really strange, but it was fun. It was a fun day of doing that. I got a call from him this morning that he was going to do that, and he called and asked if I wanted to help, and so I quickly got today's video edited and got it uploading, and so yeah, it was quite the thing. And then it just sat and uploaded while I was gone. So we're gonna go back here, and we're gonna get the auger set up on the bin. Put our duals back on here. So we need this bin here. it up. Go. Hop back in this guy. Go up a few gears here. Let's not hit them, no. Avoid hitting the power line as well. We got a bunch of clearance here, though. Alright, so we'll back this guy pretty much straight up, and hopefully we'll fill all 29 of our bins. Not just from beans, but between the beans and the corn, hopefully we'll fill the remaining 14 grain bins that we have. Whoa, wrong way. I'm going to start kind of dropping it. Going to see where we're at. Pull ahead. Turn a little bit here. I'm turning the wrong way. Whoa. Turning the wrong way here. Great demand for corn. If only we were combining corn, we'd just haul it straight to the elevator, but we're not. Right. So yeah, the grain cart, if you guys noticed, it does not have fill planes for beans. It just is using the wheat fill plane, but then it does not have a unload particle for it. I had been meaning to go in and change it or add one, but just never have. Just take a grain cart that does have the fill planes for it and copy everything over and put it on. But yeah, I've seen a lot of comments on today's video about the yield of our wheat. That's an unrealistic yield. Yes, I know it is. This is a game. I can't help it. If you were running 200 plus bushels an acre, you would be sitting pretty dang well, and you'd be one rich farmer at the end of the season. Yeah, I know it's unrealistic. There's nothing I can do about it. It's either something in the map, or else we were running good enough nutrients on our fields, or, you know, nothing I can handle. You know, if it's soil mod, you know, I can't adjust that on my own, and then if it's in the map, I don't know what I'd adjust to make that. We'll turn on our animated chopper here. Turn on the animated chopper. There we go. Yeah, you can kind of see my little oopsie up there. But, you know, whatever is off of the field, it'll get put down under the ground with soil mod. Everything, really, I guess, because it'll all go under. I suppose that field over there probably went under. But, yeah, so we are going to rent a pickup truck because the 3500 GMC here is costing us a lot of money with damage mods. So we're going to rent a new truck, just something temporary. I think we'll go with my buddy's 90 Silverado. 20 days sounds good to me. I think we might end up buying this truck after we can afford to buy vehicles. So we're going to drop that there, and we're going to head this guy to the shop, and we're going to trade it in on that other truck. Holy crap, our combine is already 75% full. Jeez, what a yield. Now, if I had done slurry on all the fields, yeah, we'd have a lot of bins full already from our wheat. Our corn's looking really great. I did go in and edit the map. I removed the clip on those trees over there and then checked and made sure that checked to see if that feed shed had the fill planes in it, so that you could dump your, you know, your hay, your silage, your chaff, your forage, all that stuff in there. It does not, which is what I was hoping, because that's where we are going to stack all of our bales. Another thing Yesterday I opened a checking account, and there's a website called Polygonish. It's polygonish.com. They have fairly cheap 3D models, and just the other day they came out with a, or a few days ago I guess, came out with a Massey Ferguson Heston Swather model. And there's two models. You can either buy both the swathers and both the headers for $60, or you can buy individual ones for $30. I'm not going to be able to release it, because to do that, it would cost me like $400. So I can't release it, but another buddy of mine, the guy that did the Pete 579 that we're using, he bought one swather model, so I'm going to buy the other one, and we'll just kind of flip-flop, and we'll both have both of the models, and then we'll collab on them, work on them together somewhat, and then, so then we'll have a new swather. Here, I'll show you guys it here. We'll open a new window here, and we'll go polygonish.com. So there's a few things I'm going to buy. If we type in Massey here. So this is the one that my buddy bought. It's a Massey Ferguson Heston WR9870. This one has the tractor tires on it and then the draper header. It does have to be separated and re-AO'd to work with Farm Sim, but that's all right. And then the one I'm buying, it's the same swather model. Only difference is this has the hay head and then it has different tires on it. So I'm buying this, this Chandler 24 RDT tender trailer, and then it'll be scripted for seed and fertilizer. It'll be a nice addition. Actually, I want to go all here. And then I'm also going to buy this 1265 Case IH planter. I think it's a 48 row or 24 row, something like that. 24, I'm guessing. And it's got track system on it. So I'm going to buy all that stuff and work on that. So yeah, that'll be some nice additions. I said this in Thursday's video. If you have not already checked it out, on my mod site, I did three releases on Wednesday. I cannot hit the brakes. That's a bad idea. I released my fuel trailer and then updated versions of my stack movers. Basically, the only things I changed in them was a couple of XML things, and then I had added the store category script to it. Here you can see this is one of the grain bins for my map. It's an edit that I did of the Twister bins from American Eagle's modding. I just made some texture changes to it, some scaling changes, and then I built a couple of pieces for it to make it be somewhat close to the bin that is there in real life. It's not exact, but it's close enough. I will have to build some bins for it, but if I can avoid building a lot of bins, I'll be happy. And that bin was just about the same capacity, so it's really close in the same size as the bins there. So I just figured, well, you know what, why not just use it and, use it and make some changes, and then it'll be good. So we're going to top off the fuel trailer here. I don't know why I keep getting so much damage. No, I want to fill the trailer, not empty it. I know I need to first fill the implement. That's what I'm trying to do. Oh, that's right, I think the trigger is on the side. Yeah. No, the trigger's back here, that's right. Pretty sure. Yeah, I think I placed this thing backwards. I think. Trying to remember how this thing fills. I know it fills somehow, but how, I do not remember. There we go. On that side, just like that. Wow, we got a full grain cart coming our way. That'll fill up the truck, I hope. Yeah, you're gonna be stupid and drive over the beans. Go figure. So our combine is just gonna want to sit here until grain cart gets back and fills, or empties. Okay, really? You're gonna be stupid again? Gotta love it. Stupid course plate driver. Boy, are these beans heavy. I did talk, somebody said it in the comments, back when I was doing my Lost Hills multiplayer server videos, I asked, you know, if you guys knew, you know, soybeans were a really heavy crop, you know, let me know and whatever, and a lot of people said, yeah, they're about the heaviest crop, and so, I'm not sure how this 579 is going to handle this. With the wheat, it was a little light, so I'm not sure how it's going to react to these beans. I think I would like, after this, you know, after the harvest season is over, I might look into trading this off on a bigger truck. Just the hopper trailer truck. We'll keep the blue one for our tender trailer, because it does a good job on that. But for our hopper trailer, this gets too heavy sometimes, so I think we might just end up trading this truck in on a different one and getting something else. So yeah, I was talking with my buddy that did this truck. He sent me some pictures. He was working on a new interior. He's redoing the interior on this and also redoing the textures on the truck. Because if we go over here, you can tell that the box and the cab are two different shades. Must have messed something up somewhere along the way and whatnot, but it's a very nice truck otherwise. It's actually based off of his real life truck. That's where he got the sounds from. He found it in the SketchUp warehouse and he ran it through Blender doing basically the same thing that I did to my C30. He, you know, joined it into a bunch of different sections of pieces rather than being in zillions of pieces. And then he also did AO textures for it. So actually, I think we can go out this way. We can just go straight ahead. Oh no, we technically can't, but we're going to anyways. We're gonna pretend that this road continues on. Yeah, these beans are really heavy on this truck. I have to let off of the gas and somewhat tap the brake just to be able to steer. But that's how the wheat was too, so it's not acting too much differently than it did with the wheat, but yeah, this truck's definitely a little bit lighter duty. It's more of like a tender trailer truck or maybe a good cattle truck. Maybe we'll keep this truck around and use this for our cattle hauling rather than buy another truck for that. We'll just buy another truck for hauling grain. And if anybody knows of any good video tutorials or of somebody that knows how to do animated doors for buildings in Blender, let me know, because with my buildings on my map, I have to make a lot of custom doors, and I have never messed with animations before in Blender. I shouldn't say that I haven't. I've done some animated stuff in Blender, but it only worked in Blender. When I exported it to Giant's editor, the animations weren't there. So I don't know how to do that. I mean, I can animate it in Blender, but I can't figure out how to get my animations to carry over so that I can, you know, have a working door when I go in game. So yeah, if anybody knows of anybody or any good video tutorials that show how to do animated doors, let me know, please. I hope to have it figured out. I just finished a building, well, other than the doors, I just finished a building here yesterday. It's a Quonset that goes right next to the elevator on my map at Temvik. So I finished that, and so then I'm going to build the doors for it, but I won't be able to do anything with the doors yet since I don't know how to do the animations. So we gotta adjust our auger here again. But I don't know why this thing like always moves. It's so annoying. That out. Whoa. Yeah, we really screwed up now. Oh man, I forgot that I raised this thing all the way up. Jeez. I can't believe I just did that. Wow. Just wow. Screenshots here. And turn all of our stuff back on. We'll get this guy unloading again. Unloading and combining again. Bring up all of our courses again. So we're running slight acidity. I never did do a test save on this map. Oh wait, yes I did. Lime is not in this map. So I'm gonna have to go to a map that has lime stuff on it and then take all that stuff off of it and put it on here, or at least just the triggers, and then put it at the crop production services building. Hey combine driver, you're missing beans. What missing? And then just put it at the crop production services building, along, you know, like by one of the other triggers, so that way it's, you know, that way we can buy it. So one truckload just about, it fills at 19 and, wow, almost 20% off of one truck. It's fairly decent actually. So about five loads, and that's a full bin, so that ain't too bad. So yeah, after I finish recording this video, probably not going to do a whole lot more playing on this map today. I'm going to, you know, really crack down on work on my map. I want to try and get as much stuff done on there as I can. I am going to do some video on it, like while I do power lines. I'm going to do like a time-lapse video while I do that, and then upload that for you guys on Tuesday. By the time you're watching this video, I have already done this, but I'm also going to upload a video tutorial that's going to show how to add the add store category Lua script to a mod. A guy was asking me about it, and I said I'd do a tutorial. I'm actually like a day or two off from when I said I would do it, but been busy. So, you know, that way, like, you can have your mods and you can have them in your own store category. I must have missed something in this grain bin that it's saying missing Craft Farms modding in L10N.xml. I do need to redo this trailer as well. But yeah, so all of the grain bins for my map will be in my store category because I'm going to just script the map so that when you start the game, you already own those bins and they're in their positions that they should be. And the elevator, I know, like, Joe Lindbergh put on his Wind Chaser map, it's a script that with your map, your storage, it has like a limited capacity on it. So I'm gonna look into that and see what script it is, and then look into adding it to my map for the elevator, because the elevator is just going to be a, you know, like a normal map object, but it's going to have grain station triggers in it. And then, you know, if I can figure that out, then it'll have the capacity set to 20,000 bushels, which is what that elevator is. And so then, you know, you can put any crop in there, but me, I would just put wheat in there because, you know, that's the only thing that they put in there in real life nowadays. Well, they don't use the elevator currently, actually, but when they did use it, that's all that they put in there, because you can't really put anything else in it, he said. You know, you can't put the corn in there, can't put the sunflowers in there because they just come out everywhere, he said. So, but yeah, I was talking to my papa, and he said, yeah, wheat's about the only thing that we ever put in there anymore. But lately, it, you know, it hasn't run, so they haven't had anything in there at all lately. But yeah, he said it's a 20,000 bushel capacity in there. So it's twice what the bins are. So one elevator full is two bins. So let's just make sure the grain cart's gonna actually do this correctly. And our 24 hours must have ended, so our grain cart must be re-rented. This is going to get a reply to a message. Hoping our truck is in right position. I mean, I suppose if I really, really wanted to, I could set this truck up on course play, and then I just like set a waypoint in the farm yard somewhere, so that, like, you know, like before the bins, so that it would you know, it would stop there, and then I could stop the driver, go to the bin, unload, and then set him up on his way again. But then we'd have absolutely nothing to do other than, you know, empty the truck. So we'll sit here and do this. He's barely gonna do his pass when he turns around and he's gonna fill up. Just great. I don't think this thing has a bean texture either. I guess I can just go in here and look. Nope. Just using the wheat texture as well. Now that's one thing, when I start my mods, like combines and stuff, is I'm gonna, like combines and grain carts, is add fill planes to them for all the crops on my map, which will be oats, soybeans, sunflowers, and sorghum. But yeah, so our truck is 74% full. Got a full grain cart on it. So that's gonna do it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, hit the thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Make sure to hit that subscribe button. Make sure you turn on my post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. My video schedule is Tuesdays and Thursdays at 4 p.m. Central Time, Saturdays at noon Central Time. Make sure you check out down below in the description for links to all my social medias, my mod site, and other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. And I'll see you guys on Tuesday. Thanks for watching.